on our roster, we expand now. We bring in David Haugh, who is up at Hallis Hall, and got a chance to...
Did you just call it Hallis Haugh?
In my sort of weird accent, sometimes it comes out that way. Okay. David, are you there on the phone?
I'm here.
Hey, thanks for joining us. I appreciate it. You got a chance to ask some...
great questions.
Great questions. A lot of great questions today. I think you had a few of them. A lot of great questions today. What were your first overall impressions of Trestman with your first extended chance to talk to him?
Well, I think that he's very cerebral, very lawyerly, a guy who definitely came prepared for this moment, note cards and all. I think he was somebody that didn't strike you immediately as a football coach. I think he's a guy that has been waiting for this opportunity for a long time. He's a smart guy. There's no question about it. I don't know that, you know, charisma would not be the word that I would probably, you know, use in my story tomorrow. But I think that he's somebody that put a lot of people on notice because uncertainty is scary for professional athletes. And I think that there's really not anything that we know about Marc Trestman moving forward beyond the fact that he has a very impressive offensive resume. But we don't know what kind of defense he's going to run. We don't know what he thinks about every receiver other than Brandon Marshall. We don't know how he's going to protect the quarterback, which is a priority to him. And we know that he is not sold on Jay Cutler as a franchise quarterback, or else he would have answered the question directly, because that was a great question by Brad Biggs.
I think you're right. I think you're absolutely right about that. Guys?
Hey, David, I want to ask you this. It's kind of off the subject, but I thought another decent question was when someone asked about the possibility of John Hoke, because I know they wanted to keep somebody from the defense. They wanted to keep the defensive staff in place. There's no doubt about it. I know that. But what about that possibility of a John Hoke? I know that meeting's probably going to go on this afternoon. He's looked at D coordinator positions in the past. I think the Eagles was one of them. You know, he's a Ball State guy. What do you think about that?
That aside, I think he's qualified.
Oh, come on, David. All roads lead back to Muncie. You and I know that.
I know. I'm kidding. He's a great candidate, but they haven't talked yet about that possibility. He's a guy who's going to be one of several in the mix. I just talked to Phil Emery here just inside the lobby, and they're going to consider all people from all different levels, and it's going to be very similar to the Bears head coaching search, and they may end up being looking at college coaches to be the defensive coordinator. John Hoke makes sense because of continuity, but I don't know that that's important now that Rod Marinelli has left the building. I think that, you know, that was part of the interview process, the idea that he would be willing to, you know, stay. But I'm not sure anybody really gauged Rod Marinelli's realistic chances of staying. That may have been maybe one of the flaws of the process, is that if you hire a guy who is open to keeping the old staff, did you talk to the old staff about how open they were to staying? Mm-hmm. So John Hoke is a tremendous candidate. He knows the guys. He knows the system. He has interviewed for jobs in the past. But right now, there has been no movement in that direction.
David, I couldn't figure out whether somebody was lying or incapable of I'm not sure what. But when he was talking about, when Marc Trestman was saying, when he was refusing to give essentially scouting reports on what he saw specifically with Bears players or units because he hadn't seen enough tape, I kept coming back to the question, how did you get the job? What did you and Phil talk about for all that time? Don't you have to tell him how this team, how you're going to make this team win with this talent? So where do you think the truth is in all of that verbal tap dancing?
The truth is that he's not going to reveal anything to the media. I think the truth is that he understands what the Bears have and what they don't have. He's studied, you know, the personnel a lot closer than he revealed publicly and will ever reveal publicly. I think we're dealing with the guy who will be very comfortable keeping information as under lock and key, as well as the general manager did during the whole search process. So this is not going to be, you know, the era of transparency did not dawn today at Hallis Hall. So he knows a lot more than he's letting on. But I think the fact that he was not willing to say anything publicly about strengths or weaknesses probably gives you a glimpse of how he's going to handle, you know, shortcomings of players in the future. This is not going to be a guy that is candid in terms of holding people publicly accountable. Players, they'll probably appreciate that. The media won't, but I don't think we matter up here.
But he said we matter. He said he wanted to retract it from his book. He said we matter.
I didn't read the book yet.
All right, hey, David.
It's being shipped by Amazon.com right now.